Thank you for tuning into our tutorial. Over the next 10 minutes, I will introduce you to the RNMA Mode R package, which performs Bayesian network meta-analysis while accounting for missing participant outcome data. A very huge thank you to my colleagues Chrysostomos Kalivas and Katerina Papadimitropoulou for their continuing support and contribution to the package. Although network meta-analysis is probably a well-known topic to the participants of this tutorial, I provide a super quick refresher on network meta-analysis, and in the next slide I discuss the link with synthesizing trials with missing participant data. Network meta-analysis is more than just an evidence synthesis tool. It was originally developed to provide evidence for interventions not directly compared in any trial of the dataset. What makes this tool even more magnificent is that under specific circumstances, it can provide more precise results than pairwise meta-analysis for the same comparisons. It can also give a hierarchy of interventions from best to worst for a specific outcome and patient population. Missing data are widespread in clinical trials where participants often leave the trial early for reasons relevant or not to the conduct of the trial. Broadly, there are three key approaches in handling missing outcomes at clinical trial level, which can be also used at evidence synthesis level. Specifically, exclusion, which, as the name implies, deletes any participants from the sample when the outcomes are missing. Imputation, which maintains a sample size by making some assumptions about the missing outcome and taking these assumptions for granted. For example, all missing participants might have experienced the event of interest. Lastly, a more refined approach is to use the pattern mixture model. The pattern mixture model is a mixture of the outcome distribution in completers and missing participants. The RNMA Mode R package implements this approach as a standard functionality. The RNMA Mode R package was originally developed to address the lack of functions for handling missing participants in pairwise and network meta-analysis in existing R packages. This was around 2021. Now, since then, one thing led to another, and we expanded our goals to create a comprehensive suite of functions to perform and visualize Bayesian pairwise and network meta-analysis. In this teaser tutorial, we will present you the core functions of the package for modeling and visualization. You may install and load the package directly from CRAN by running these lines. However, we do recommend installing the development version to experience the latest advances of the package. We will use the dataset of Baker and colleagues on COPD. The outcome is whether the patients experience COPD exacerbation after receiving the randomized intervention. You can run this line to see the first six trials. You see that the dataset has this one trial per row format, which is the typical format found in Bayes language models. To create a network plot, use the netplot function. The function currently calls the NMA network plot function from the PCNMeta R package. The netplot function gives further insights into the network evidence by printing three tables on the console. This is a table that describes the network evidence. The next is a table that summarizes the trials, randomized sample, and outcome for each intervention. And likewise for each observed comparison in the network plot. Well, this is a snapshot of a quite lengthy table. The Baker dataset has many missing participants in most trials, interventions, and comparisons. We will use the heatmap missing dataset function to view the missing participants in percent in the dataset. You can see that most trials have interventions with high level of missingness, judging by the reddish color, with only a few trials having zero or low missingness rate, the green color. Next, we use the heatmap missing network function to view the median and rates of missing participants in percent for each intervention on the main diagonal of the table and observe comparison in the lower off diagonal. This network summarizes all functions of the package responsible for running the models and presenting the results. The run model function corresponds to the largest node because it is literally the backbone of the entire RNMA mode architecture. This function conducts Bayesian network meta-analysis while accounting for missing participants using the pattern mixture model. Most functions in the package cannot work without the run model function. And on its own, the run model function simply returns a bulk of raw results from the model parameters. The magic happens once the run model function is fed into the other functions of the package. So let's run a Bayesian random effects network meta-analysis while addressing the missing participants. The effect measure of interest is the odds ratio. We assign a half-normal prior distribution on the between-trial standard deviation with a scale parameter equal to 1. We will estimate one Naimor parameter for each intervention in the network. The model operates under the MISIC at random assumption on average with a variance equal to 1. The outcome is harmful. The function RAND model and all other model functions run in JAX via the R2JAX R package. Of course, do not forget to assign a name to the function, here under RES, to be used as an object in the other functions of the package. Use the MCMC diagnostics function to check the model's convergence. This function returns several such panel of bar plots for the parameters of the model. However, here we illustrate only for the locus ratio of all possible comparisons in the network. MCMC diagnostics also call the MCMC plot function of the MCMC plots R package that returns a HTML files with several diagnostic plots for the monitor parameters that we have specified in the par argument here, namely the locus ratio of all possible comparisons, EM, and the common between-trial standard deviation. This is just a snapshot of a lengthy HTML file. Now we move on to the core visualization of the network meta-analysis results. The leak heat map function creates the popular leak table. The table is read as row versus columns and shows the posterior median odds ratio, a 95% credible interval for each comparison. The interventions are sorted in decreasing order by the posterior mean SUCRA value, which appears in the main diagonal of the table. The larger the treatment effect, the darker the color shade. The leak heat map function can also display the treatment effects from two outcomes or a selected subset of interventions, which is ideal when we deal with huge networks. The leak heat map PRENT function has the same arguments as the leak heat map function, but as you may suspect, it displays the predictions for all possible pairwise comparisons in the network. A compact alternative to leak table is to create a forest plot of comparisons with a selected comparator intervention. For illustration, we have selected Budesidone as the reference and we run the following code to obtain the forest plots where results on estimation and prediction co-appear. In plot A, the 95% credible intervals, the black lines, overlain with the 95% prediction intervals, the orange lines. Now, in both plots, the interventions found in the psi-axis are sorted from best to worst based on the SUCRA value found in plot B. The RANCO SUCRA plot function creates a plot for each intervention that combines two popular hierarchy plots, namely the RACONGRAM and the SUCRA plot. The interventions are sorted from best to worst based on the SUCRA value, the number on the top left corner of each plot. The RANCO SUCRA plot function can also display the hierarchy results from two outcomes. We can explore the implications of assuming consistency, a common heterogeneity, as opposed to performing pairwise meta-analysis separately for each observed comparison in the network. First, use the RAND series meta function to conduct separate pairwise meta-analysis for all observed comparisons in the network. Next, insert meta into the function series meta plot to experience the visualization toolkit for this analysis. This function returns the same results in two formats. One, a table that is printed on the console, and second, a panel of forest plots. Here we present the plots. We can see in plot A that network meta-analysis produced more precise results than pairwise meta-analysis for all observed comparisons. The same benefits are also evident for the heterogeneity parameter, which was estimated at a reasonable level, judging by the color key, and with greater precision than in any pairwise meta-analysis. By the way, the plot vertical lines refer to the posterior median and 95% credible interval of the common heterogeneity parameter. For the local evaluation of consistency, we have considered the node splitting approach. The RAN node split function applies the node splitting approach with the synergy of the R-package KMTC to select the proper nodes to split. Next, we insert the node into the node splitting plot to get the necessary results both in tabular and graphical format. The first graph is a panel of interval plots to check consistency through the inconsistency factor, namely the difference between direct and indirect estimate. For each split node, we can see the estimated direct effect from pairwise meta-analysis, the indirect effect after removing the corresponding comparison from the network, and the inconsistency factor, indicated as IF. The deviance information criterion for each model appear on the top left of each plot. The plots have been sorted in ascending order of the deviance information criterion. We see that the 95% credible interval for the consistency factor crosses the vertical line of consistency in all plots. Now, one may conclude that the consistency assumption holds. However, we see that the point estimate is not even close to zero in all plots. The next graph is a, so to say, reversed forest plot on the between trial standard deviation after each split node. Again, the split nodes have been sorted in ascending order of the deviance information criterion. The blue horizontal lines refer to the posterior median, a 95% credible interval of the common heterogeneity parameter in network meta-analysis. As a global evaluation of consistency, we apply the unrelated mean effects model using the UME model function. Next, we insert UME into the UME plot function to shed light on the validity of consistency globally through a variety of results in tabular and graphical format. The first panel of graphs consists of a scatter plot on the left and a Blatt Altman plot on the right, on the posterior mean deviance under the network meta-analysis and unrelated mean effects model. The next panel includes the leverage plot under network meta-analysis on the left and unrelated mean effects model on the right. Lastly, a panel of interval plots on the odds ratio under both models, but only for the pairwise comparisons that we observe in the network. We conclude this teaser tutorial with the network meta-regression. First, we used the run meta-reg function to run the model, and as you may have guessed by now, we insert reg into the function meta-reg plot to obtain several results in tabular and graphical format. We will glimpse into the plots. We will present the results for publication year 2002 and for Budesidon as the selected comparator. In plot A, the 95% credible intervals, the black lines, overlap with the 95% prediction intervals, colored lines. The odds ratios refer to comparisons with Budesidon, the selected comparator intervention. In both plots, the interventions are sorted from best to worst based on the sigma value found in plot B. The hierarchy of the interventions does not seem to materially change when comparing the two models regarding the sigma values for the publication year 2002. With this teaser tutorial, we have presented the main functionalities of the RNMA mode R package. We highly recommend to browse through the manual to dive in the technical details of the functions. For any questions about the tutorial and the RNMA mode R package, feel free to contact me. Thank you very much.